Hello. So here, these twos simplify. And the sine of all of this is sine of 60 degrees. Cosine of all of this is cosine of negative 13 degrees. Cosine is an even function. So that's going to turn into a positive 13 degrees. The denominator, this turns into 30 degrees, cosine 13 degrees. So here, cosine over cosine simplifies. Sine of 60 degrees, that is going to be radical 3 over 2, and sine of 30 degrees is 1 half. So this gives us radical 3. So all of this is the same as radical 3. Okay, let's prove this identity. So here we have cosine alpha minus cosine beta. This looks the same as then in the denominator, we have the sum of two sines, and that looks the same as interesting. Whatever value this is, it's the same value as here. And it's negative 2 times this blue times this. These are the same values. Therefore, they simplify. The 2s simplify. So we have so this is my alpha, n minus 2 times theta. And then in the denominator, it's n minus 2 times theta. And beta of the denominator. Notice these angles are the same. Well, we can simplify that. Oh, I forgot the dividing by 2. Look at that. Now, sine is an odd function, so this is going to be cosine is an even function, so this is going to be so here we have sine of a first angle times sine of a second angle. This has the structure So this is This is strictly the left-hand side. Okay, let's rewrite this and drop the parentheses. Here, beta minus beta is 0. Here, alpha minus alpha is 0. Well, let's apply the double angle formulas. And this is because because cosine 2 theta is equal to cosine squared theta minus sine squared theta. So cosine of 2 beta is equal to cosine squared beta minus sine squared beta. Okay, and also applied it to the alphas. This is going to be when you distribute the negative. So let's make these all into cosines. So here we have 1 cosine squared beta plus 1 cosine squared beta is going to be 2 cosine squared beta. Okay. We have a minus 1 plus 1 is 0. Minus cosine squared is minus 2 cosine squared of alpha. Multiply all of that by 1/2. All right. Now, since the right-hand side is in sine squareds, let's convert these into sine squareds and see what happens. So I guess over here it would have been quicker for me to put all of these into sine squareds since that's what the final answer is going to be. I chose cosine squared because it was first. Cosine squared beta is 1 minus sine squared beta, and then minus whatever cosine squared alpha is equal to. Cosine squared alpha is equal to 1 minus sine squared alpha. Drop the parentheses. We have 1 minus 1 is 0. We have sine squared alpha minus sine squared beta. And that's the left-hand side. And the right-hand side. All right, convert to a product. Well, let's see what happens if we convert all these into single thetas. So this is equal to No, I'm not liking that. We are at 16 minutes. Please go to tutoring. Thank you.